knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Continuing through Lophophorata, we reach phylum Brachiopoda. Brachiopods, or lamp shells, were once extremely common in our oceans. They flourished in the Paleozoic and Mesozoic eras. There are some 30,000 fossil brachiopod species known, but only around 385 species are alive today. They are found in very cold water, in polar regions, or in the deep sea, and are rarely seen. They are an entirely marine phylum. Not a single species exists in freshwater or the terrestrial environment. Extant forms closely resemble fossil forms, and at least one genus, Lingula, has remained virtually identical to its fossil forms from 440 million years ago. Though they superficially resemble the molluscan bivalves, the two are separate phyla that inhabit similar niches. We'll study them by going over form and function, feeding, circulation, nervous systems, and reproduction and development. Like the bivalves, the lamp shells also have two hard shells, or valves. However, the lamp shells' valves cover their upper and lower surfaces, while bivalve shells cover their left and right sides. In addition, unlike the bivalves, lamp shell valves are unequal in size and structure. They are not mirror images. Brachiopod valves are hinged at the rear end, while the front can be opened for feeding or closed for protection. They are traditionally split into articulate and inarticulate groups. Articulate brachiopods have toothed hinges and simple, vertically oriented opening and closing muscles, while inarticulate brachiopods have weak, untoothed hinges and a more complex system of vertical and oblique, or diagonal, muscles used to keep the two valves aligned. In many brachiopods, a stalk-like pedicle projects from an opening near the hinge of one of the valves, known as the pedicle or ventral valve. The pedicle, when present, keeps the animal anchored to the seabed, but clear of sediment, which would obstruct the opening. Some, like Lingula, live in vertical burrows in the sand or mud. Modern brachiopods are small, usually between 10 and 30 millimeters in length, though the largest extinct species reached a length of more than 30 centimeters. Like bryozoans and phoronids, brachiopods have a lophophore, a crown of tentacles whose cilia create a water current that enables them to filter food particles out of the water. A lamp shell lophophore is generally U-shaped and forms brachia that gives the phylum its name. These lophophores are non-retractable and occupy up to two-thirds of the animal's internal space. They are often intricately folded into complex shapes. Using the lophophore, lamp shells create a flow of water that enters from the sides and exits through the front. As the water passes over the lophophore, it captures food particles, usually tiny phytoplankton. Captured food is delivered to the mouth, which is a tiny slit at the base of the lophophore. Food that enters the mouth passes through the muscular pharynx into the stomach, where it is digested and distributed to the body through their open circulatory system, meaning their blood mixes with other fluids and bathes their organs. Brachiopods have a notoriously low metabolic rate, about one-tenth that of bivalves. Ancient brachiopods likely inhabited warm waters around the world. However, most of these former niches are now occupied by bivalves. The extremely slow metabolism of modern brachiopods is an adaptation to life in cold and low-light conditions where bivalves are not found. Lamp shells have colorless blood that is pumped through the body by their contractile heart. The wastes produced by metabolism are broken down into ammonia, which is eliminated by diffusion through the mantle and lophophore. They absorb oxygen and eliminate carbon dioxide through their mantle and lophophore. The lamp shell nervous system is still being studied. Though they have a brain that consists of two ganglia, some of their sensory mechanisms are not yet fully understood. For example, lamp shells can close their valves if shadows appear above them, but how they sense the shadows is unknown, since they seem to lack eyes and photoreceptive cells. However, the edge of their mantle does contain a high concentration of chemical receptors. The lifespan of a lamp shell seems to range between 3 and 30 years, and varies by species. Most species are dioecious and have four separate gonads. Most species spawn by releasing sperm and eggs into the water at the same time, but females of some species brood their young by holding eggs inside their bodies and fertilizing them with sperm that they filter out of the water column. Fertilized eggs hatch into larvae that resemble miniature adults in some species. Some are born with tiny shells. Others are born without shells. Usually, the larvae are free-swimming or planktonic. Some may drift for months as their shells develop. Eventually, as the shell becomes heavier, they sink to the bottom, find a suitable attachment place, and become a sessile adult. And that wraps up our summary of the lampshells. Let's move forward and finish up all of Spiralia with an overview of the horseshoe worms.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.